Welcome to 2021 Computex Cyber World Forum. My name is Frank Welling. I am from Andes Technology Corporation. Today, I'm going to talk about the smart electric vehicle to everything communication solutions. In the beginning, let me share with you some data of how and why electric vehicle will dominate the market. In the graph at the left, you can see that global annual passenger vehicle sales by year forecast. In year 2040, the amount of electric vehicle will reach more than 40 million per year. And the CAGR is very high. Then in the right side, comparing traditional car and electric vehicle, you could see that by the year, around year 2035, the global share of total annual passenger vehicle will have a kind of a golden cross. At that time, electric vehicle will lead the traditional cars. Then in terms of different countries, from today to year 2030, you can see that countries like China and the US, they will dominate the global EV market. However, gradually, each country, rest of the world, they will also come out with more electrical vehicle market. Then comparing different kind of classes of vehicle, from small, medium, to like a bus or even SUV, you could see that the growth rate is also high. According to Taiwan's ETRI, in year 2040, 31% of vehicles on the road will be electric vehicle. Let's take a further look. In terms of car, the vehicles on the road. Let's talk about bus. It's expected 67% of bus will be electric. 47% of motorcycles will be electric. 24% of commercial cars will be electric at that time. Further, let's take a look at the driving forces of an electric vehicle market growth. There are four of them. User attitude, car manufacturer's strategy, government policy, and enterprise's role. Let's take a further look. For example, farther driving range, widespread charging utility, or in-house charging utility, less cost and more incentive. These are the factors that user will change their attitude to adopt EV. For car manufacturers, more efficient alternatives they pump up every year. They change or promote new cars. They give more cool features, and they could name a more competitive price and start to promote more programs. And then take a look at the government roles. Countries, governments, they must follow the emission standard of CO2. Also, they made commitment to carbon neutrality. So, they adopt a way to grant tax incentive or finance incentive to the user or car manufacturers. Then, enterprise's role. They intend to support EV. That will bring the positive image to company or the company's group. They show positive responsibility to Earth. So they could overall adopt EV in a enterprise so that the overall cost will go down. And the overall employees' satisfaction level will grow. All these are the driving forces of the EV market growth. Now, what is vehicle to everything communication? This is a revolutionary technology. It's a wireless technology that enables communication between the vehicles, infrastructures, and other devices in the vicinity, grid, home, and the network. Taking a look at the graph shown here, you could see that from vehicle, vehicle to pedestrians, vehicle to network, and vehicle to infrastructures. All these kind of wireless communication are included in V2X. This technology helps the vehicle to receive warning regarding real-time traffic and alerts related to accidents or other hurdles. V2X capable vehicles can assist in better traffic management, leading to greener vehicles and lower fuel costs. So, V2X could be pioneer for fully autonomous driving. It will help to bring better autonomous driving experience. V2X could help paving the way for fully autonomous driving through its unique non-line of sight sensing capability, which allows vehicles to detect potential hazards, traffic, and road conditions from longer distances and sooner than other in-vehicle sensors such as cameras, radar, and LiDAR. From the graph in this page, borrowed from Qualcomm, you could see that their solution in V2X will leverage the technology of Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, 4G, 5G, and V2X itself to grant a V2X solution and the precise positioning of a car. Now, let me use this slide to forecast the V2X market. The global spending on V2X is expected to grow at a CAGR of more than 170% between 2019 and 2022. More than 11.2 million light vehicles equipped with some form of a V2X system will be produced during this time frame and to year 2024. And the compound annual growth rate is expected to be 277%. So, what are the major technologies in V2X? There are two of them. One is called DSRC, Dedicated Short-Range Communication. The other is CV2X, which is cellular connectivities. I put quite a lot of standards here. However, overall, you could see that for DSRC, they are Wi-Fi technology based. And for CV2X, they are cellular, which means 5G or 3G PP based. It's a basic idea for vehicles communication. Wi-Fi in the long range is less competitive than cellular. So 5G should be dominant in the future. We could see that in United States, industries from car makers and technology companies, they already supported 5G AA, which is 5G Automotive Association. 5G AA already brought up waiver request. They seek for permission to deploy cellular vehicle to everything technology in a portion of the 5.9 gigahertz band, which means they like to share the bandwidth with the DSRC. Let's take a look at the V2X supply chain. In terms of a supply chain, in the left side of the slide, you could see that from the basic semiconductor and the chip and components segment up to more component side, then to the car makers, these are the supply chain direction. And in the right side, you could see that for DSRC and the CV2X, they have their group of supply chains already. And this kind of a supply chain are distributed worldwide. However, today, in terms of Computex cyber world, I would like to introduce further regarding Taiwan's supply chain, the infrastructure which could help you. For example, in the past, we all know that Taiwan has its basic strong background in ICT and the semiconductor industry. For example, personal computers, smartphones, now leverage MIH EV open platform. Foxconn, they will lead a consortium to enter smart EV segment. So there will be 1,000 partners allied in this partner funnel, go to market together. They will provide key solution and the modularities to the market. For example, this platform will bring innovation of electric vehicle to autonomous driving system as well as vehicle motion control, so that the alliances partners from automotive industry suppliers, ICT component suppliers, software providers, cloud connectivity providers, together they will bring solution to mobility service providers and the car brands. In vehicle, you have to talk about the function safety requirements. ISO 26262, our ASIL, is required sometimes. However, today, most market available SoCs are not dedicated for V2X because they were made for mobile phone or networking. So it's not necessarily today everything is ISO 26262 or ASIL required. However, in the future, roadside unit will be required for SLB. And the onboard unit will require SLB as minimum and the SLC or D for a main drive purpose. Then, again, for electric vehicle, it's more strict that SLB is required as minimum and SLC or D is required for a main drive purpose. What Andes, the company I'm from, can provide for EV and V2X. Let me separate for non-SL requirement and SL requirement. For non-SL requirement, for EV, ADAS and the vehicle motion control unit will require the requirement will be satisfied by Andes V5 course, such as 2045 series, For V2X, a major SoC will be satisfied by V545 series on OBU and 2527 series for cost-down devices such as RSU. Then for SL requirement, SLB certified CPU is on the way. Last but not least, I'd like to conclude that electric vehicle, smart EV, will dominate the market gradually. Smart EV requires a V2X communication. In Taiwan, there are supply chains for smart EV V2X platforms. Taking MIH as an example, it is an open platform for this kind of supply chains. Then Andes is one of MIH and will provide a solution for CPU required for EV and V2X. Yet, there are more for you to dig out in Taiwan. We hope you leverage Computex CyberWorld to provide you with the platform and the solution for EV and V2X. That's my presentation today. Thank you.